I watched Spider-Verse for the 5th time to prepare for Across the Spider-Verse, and I found one aspect of Spider-Man's philosophy, which is the I never quit, Spider-Man always gets back up, that could have actually corrupted Miles and made him become something more like the Prowler, like his uncle. This is because there's two ways to interpret this philosophy. One is the Spider-Man way, and one is the way that Miles' family teaches him that, because of their generational trauma. So today we'll study the characters of Miles, Jefferson and Uncle Aaron to find out how it affects them, where their trauma comes from, how it's related to Spider-Man, and how it is ultimately fixed. Oh, and if you haven't seen Across the Spider-Verse yet, don't worry, this video will not contain spoilers for that. But with that said, let's get into it. In the movie, there's this belief that there can only be one Spider-Man.
There's only one Spider-Man. And you're looking at him.
There can only be one success story. Spider-Man is just a word for success, for having a fulfilling life, for doing great things. Things that Miles doesn't believe he can do, because deep down, he hates himself. Because his father doesn't approve of the way he is, the things he likes.
It doesn't feel like I have a choice.
You don't!
And he's in the center of all of these expectations that his teachers and his father have on him. They have their own vision for Miles' future. But what about Miles' vision for his future? Jesus, I feel so identified with this guy. This is all reflected in Spider-Man as well, because Jefferson hates Spider-Man.
Spider-Man. I mean, this guy swings in once a day, zip-zap-zop in his little mask and answers to no one, right?
And because he hates Spider-Man, Miles doesn't have, like, permission to be Spider-Man until his father gives him the approval he needs. Or until he learns to love himself for who he is and not for who his father wants him to be.
You really hate Spider-Man?
Yeah, I mean, with a vigilante.
And this is all passed down from Jefferson and Aaron's father to him, generations after. This isn't explicitly said in the movie, but part of why this movie is so good is there's a lot of subtext and you can deduce these things without them having to tell you explicitly. I bet that Aaron and Jefferson's, Jefferson is Miles' dad, by the way, Aaron and Jefferson's dad was also a policeman. And when they were young, Aaron says that Jefferson would often go around doing graffiti on the streets. They both liked that lifestyle. Soon enough, their father's vision for their future was imposed on Jefferson and he gave in. He turned into a policeman, yes, like his father wanted. But Aaron didn't comply. And not only that, he felt so betrayed by his own brother for giving in that he didn't feel the support he needed to make his dreams come true. And he ended up resorting to crime and becoming the Prowler to pay the bills and to make something of himself, something that made him feel powerful, like that superpowered suit. That's why after that, when he dies, he says to Miles that he just wanted him to feel proud of him, almost like he sees a bit of his own dad in Miles. But we are getting ahead of ourselves. Let's go back a little. As the movie goes on, Miles finds a new family in the Spider People. And these Spider People tell a very similar lesson to his own family. Never quit.
Above all, no matter how many times you get hit, can you get back up?
His father tells him, in this family, we never quit. And even his own mother tells him,
can I sleep here tonight?
Miles, it's a weeknight. You made a commitment to that school.
Jeff.
In this family, we don't run away from...
Our family doesn't run from things, Miles.
I also find it really funny how Jefferson calls Aaron at some point and says, hey, Miles is really fond of you. Have you seen him?
Look, I need you to call me if you've heard from Miles. He has a soft spot for you.
It's not that he's fond of Aaron for no particular reason. It's because Aaron actually supports Miles and doesn't try to make him something that he's not. He appreciates Miles for who he is.
Real Miles coming out of hiding.
The real Miles coming out of hiding and pushes him to what Miles really wants to do. He gives him the support, he lifts him up so that he can get higher than he ever could in the things that he actually feels passionate. But Jefferson keeps insisting on this idea that you can never quit, you can never quit the school, you can never quit anything, even though that thing is making you miserable. It's not the right thing for you. How could this turn him into a Prowler? Well, it's really simple, because we tend to follow the paths of the people that support us. So
if the one person that supports you happens to also be a super criminal like the Prowler, it's definitely not a good place to start. This doesn't actually end up happening, for reasons that I'll discuss later.
On the other hand, in the spider people, they never quit, they never stay down when they hit you. How many times can you get hit and get up after? This means that people in the world will try to hurt you and put you down and put your ideas down and your dreams down. But you cannot let them win. You have to stand up and rise and fight for what you believe is the right thing to do, and fight for what is right for you, because it is your life. Same sentence, but two different meanings, depending on who you are talking to. And to break the cycle, the family, Miles' family needs to realize this, that not all things are worth quitting. The only thing not worth quitting is one's own dreams, and you shouldn't put down someone's dreams just because they don't equal to your dreams, or your dreams for that person. So how is this generational trauma broken? Well, it all starts with Aaron, because he does quit. He quits being the Prowler when Kingpin orders him to kill Miles and he doesn't comply. Even though before he says,
"You know me, sir, I don't ever quit."
So he quits that, and obviously it was too late for him and Kingpin kills him. But this starts a chain reaction in which Jefferson, when he sees the premature death of his own brother, realizes that he can't let Miles follow the footsteps of Aaron. He knows that everything happened because he didn't support his brother, and his dad didn't support him. And because of that lack of support, he ended up going through that life of crime and left him to his death.
And here, this is the key moment. Right now, Miles is feeling desperate. He's really feeling incredibly sad because both of the death of his uncle and the betrayal of his friends who left him behind, his inability to become Spider-Man because of his father's inability to support him, could have sparked some hatred towards his dad and some admiration towards his uncle, which could have made him wanna follow in his footsteps, the footsteps of the only person in the world who seemed to understand and support him. If there can only be one Spider-Man, well, there have to be two Prowlers then. Fortunately, Jefferson does not allow this to happen.
I see this spark in you. It's amazing. It's why I push you, but it's yours. Whatever you choose to do with it, you'll be great.
Man, I wish my own father told me this. You know, I've been really struggling with YouTube, and I really want to make videos about movies and analyze them to you. I get all of this pushback from my family telling me, "You have to study, you have to study." But I don't want to, I want to do this. I feel so happy while making these videos. But anyway, when Miles finally is able to get this support from his father, he's able to do amazing things. The generational trauma is broken, and this all leads to the leap of faith, the best scene in the movie. I get really emotional with this scene because it shows how far one person can go with the right support. So I want to tell you right now, if you are struggling with something that you like but aren't sure if it's for you, because your family or anyone else tells you that you can, please know that you have here a friend who understands. But I'm not in another dimension, so please write me a comment or something. Tell me about your shit, man. I'm literally going through the same thing. I think we can help each other. But yeah, just like Miles says at the end of the movie, anyone can wear the mask, but only those who are strong enough to pursue their dreams, even though they don't have the support from their family. You don't need that support. You can do great things. You can be a Spider-Man. There is not only one Spider-Man. There's not only one success story. You can make your own success story right now. And you might even help other people on their way. You will certainly help a lot of people along the way by doing what's good for you. Because when you are good, you are in the perfect position to help other people. Just like Miles is able to help Peter B. Parker to overcome his own fear of not being a father. And if you want to know more about Peter B. Parker, you should watch this video. Thank you for your attention, and see you on the next one.